there's a fine balancing point for keeping roads safe, and that's what we're really trying to do, and do it in as environmentally friendly of a way as we possibly can.
Pretty much everybody uses brine as far as the cities and counties surrounding.
It makes sense that brine's coming back and that we're using more and more of it. There's less salt content in brine. Environmentally, it's a more sound practice.
We apply it at the spinner of the salt truck. It pre-wets the salt, so it kind of sticks to the road a little better. You get less bounce.
We went and got about 1,000 gallons of pickle brine, and we just happened to have a vendor locally for this particular product. This is a waste product that is about 85% of what we kind of want. We didn't want to jump blindly, and we did a whole host of testing, lab testing. Found out pretty quickly that we weren't really ready. So we applied for an OPRA grant. We had to buy some automated equipment. An automated brine maker really saves time on staff. You turn it on and the machine runs. You put the salt in the hopper and the machine just does it for you. You don't have to think about making those minor adjustments. We save some money by getting the salt brine from our local vendor. We're saving some water, we're saving some salt. The value is really going to be in the long-term effects that it has on the environment that's out there. We all want to leave a better place for our kids. We want our lakes and streams to be healthy forever. We want our roads to be safe. We want all that to function perfectly.